Greetings. All our videos have subtitles, so you can use them if you don't understand what I say. Today we will be introducing backdrops in the Daz Studio. The backdrop is usually an image that is used as a background for your renders. To start using a backdrop, we will need an environment pane. It is usually near the scene window, on the right side of the interface. If it is not there for you, go to the window, panes list and find it here. In this window, we can see the only available option to choose the type. By default, it is set to none and we can change it to the backdrop to activate it. The viewport becomes white and we see a couple of new settings appear. This white coloring is our backdrop. We can change its color by changing the background setting values. When I add a character, you can see that it is always in front of the background. The same goes for the renders view, we can see the character in front of the chosen color. Notice that backdrop does not influence the lighting of the scene at all, no matter which color or how bright it is. One of the useful things you can do with the backdrop is set it to the green color, so now you have a green screen. Rendering scene like this, later you can use post-production to add anything onto the green background. Other settings do nothing right now. The main purpose of the backdrop is to use an image on it. You can apply any image to the backdrop if you click on the arrow and then browse. I have found this nice image of the road on thepexels.com. Made by the Sebastio Palomino. Here it is applied to the scene in the Daz Studio. It looks a bit stretched out and does not fit the frame. This is because my scene already has the dimensions set and they don't match the dimensions of the image. Fixing this is very easy, as all you need to do is open these settings in the environment window and select the adjust aspect ratio to backdrop and adjust dimensions to backdrop. You can see that both the PL size and aspect ratio were changed to match the image that was applied. Also in the environment window, you can rotate this applied image. Or flip it vertically and horizontally. Also, you can make it so it would not be present on renders. Now I will apply a pose and adjust the viewport a bit. So we can see how this looks in the rendered view. I want to change the scene a bit, so I will open the render settings window, environment section. Important not to mix up this one with the environment window, as they are totally different. Here I have adjusted the lighting a bit. I would recommend you to turn on the draw ground setting. If it is disabled, there would be no shadows on the ground. But when enabled, there are shadows, which makes the scene a lot more believable. Adjusted the scene a bit more and here is the final look. If you want to get to the backdrop images for you to use in your scenes, visit the Daz3D site. There you can find items such as this Forest Scapes Backdrops Volume 1. It has a bunch of backdrops that are themed around forests. Alternatively, there is a Mountainscapes Backdrops Volume 3. This one is built around mountain images. Overall, the Illumination user has a lot of these scapes collections that you can use. Returning to the scene. Even though this looks quite nice, it is not ideal. To be honest, it is a bit of an outdated method, as today we have another, superior way of doing the similar thing. It is an HDRI that are applied to an environment map slot. A special image that not only provides the background but also lights the scene according to an image. It is also a spherical image, which means that you can rotate around and see the character from different angles. The only way I can see backdrop being more useful is if you don't want an image to influence the lighting of a scene. If you wish to learn more about HDR images, we already have a video dedicated to this theme on our channel. Recommend you to give it a look and see how useful an HDRI can be. And also visit our website, where you can find a lot of additional information about Daz Studio, Blender, and 3D items in a text format. This video was based on such article, Daz 3D Backdrop Tutorial. You can read it if you want more information on the current topic.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get more inspiration.